Hello everyone, welcome to the video presentation on desirable quantities and different classification of instruments. So in today's video lecture, we will see what are the quantities used to measure an electrical instrument and what are the different classifications of instrument. The desirable quantities of measurement are number one, accuracy. So accuracy means the degree of exactness, or it can be defined as the degree of closeness of a measurement compared to the desired value or compared to the expected value. So you have a desired value, and what is the closeness to the desired value, that you call it as accuracy. And next definition is sensitivity. So sensitivity is the ratio of change in output to the change in input, or the change of output response of an instrument to the change in input of a measurement value. For example, if I vary the current appropriately, my voltage should vary. So a small change in the variation of current should cause a change in the output. So how fast the instrument is able to change, so that we call it as sensitivity. Next is resolution. Resolution is the smallest change for the instrument to respond. Any smallest change in a measurement value for which an instrument can respond. So that is resolution. So resolution and sensitivity both are more or less related. So when I make an make a small change in the input, so how the output responds immediately. So that we call it as resolution. So even a smallest change that it can respond is resolution. So next is precision. Precision is a measure of consistency or repeatability of values. For example, if I am conducting an experiment and noting down the values, and again in the same way, using the same method, I conduct the same instrument and again I note down the values. So when both my values are same, then there is a consistency. So that I call it as a precision. So when there is a consistency in my values, we call it as precision. So the last definition is reproducibility. The ability to reproduce or copy or obtain consistent value. So precision and reproducibility is again more or less same. So the able to reproduce. So when I conduct the experiment again, so if I'm able to reproduce or copy, or if I'm able to get a consistent result, then I call it as reproducibility. So I have given a small figure so that you can understand the accuracy and precision in a better manner. So here you can see you have a circle, and I want all my dots to fix in this circle. So here you can see the black dots are kept here and there. So it is misaligned. So which means it is low accurate. So the accuracy is low, and the precision is also low, because you have different, maybe I can say this dot has one value, this dot has another value, this dot has another value, another value. So what I require is this value, but I get a random of different values. So it has low precision and low accuracy. So even when I get values also, it is not same. So though it is randomly arranged, it is not same. So it is low accurate and low precise. And similarly, low accuracy and high precision. I want my values to be here, so that is accuracy. But I'm getting some values in one particular spot, so which means I get all the values in one particular spot, which means it says I am having a precision of values. You can see all the values are copied in a particular spot, so it is not accurate. So accuracy is I want all the values to be here, but I obtain all the values here, but the values are same. So it is accuracy is less, but it is having high precision. And if you see this figure, I want all my values here, but I am getting all my values closer to this. So the accuracy is good, but precision is less, because you have values here and there. So which means I have different values. So the accuracy is high, because it is closer to my expected value. I want my expected value to be here, and all the values are expected, which I am expecting, are closer to this. So the accuracy is high, but the precision is low, because I am having different values. So the last circle you can see, it is having high accuracy and high precision. Because I told you my objective is, I want all my values to be in the center. So as you can see, all my values are at the center. So accuracy is maintained and precision is also maintained, because you can see all the values almost at the same spot, which means you have different values and all the different values are same. So high precision, higher accuracy. So in simple, I can say accuracy means you are desiring, you want something to get, and if you are able to get closer to that desired value, it is accuracy. So I want my value to be here, and you can see my values here, so it is accurate. Precision means when you repeat the experiment again, or if you conduct the experiment again and again, and if all the values are same, then it is precise. So here you can see all my data are having almost the same value. So you can say it is having high precision. So these are the desirable quantities that are expected when you measure or when you take a particular value. And now coming to the classification of instrument. So these are three different classifications of an instrument. You can classify an instrument based on whether it is mechanical, whether it is an electrical instrument, or whether it is an electronic instrument. So electronic instrument requires less voltage. Electrical instrument, you can even operate at 230 volt. Mechanical instruments are all rotational. It rotates. Okay, so you need some mechanical force to operate. So it is a mechanical instrument. So now we are concerned with the electrical parameters. So we are going on with electrical instrument. So electrical instrument is classified into two types, absolute or indirect instrument, secondary or direct instrument. And again, secondary or direct instrument is classified into two types, analog instrument, digital instrument. And again, analog instrument is classified into two types, deflecting instrument, null deflection. And again, in deflecting instrument, it is classified into three types, indicating instrument, integrated instrument, recording instruments. So I will give basic information about all these different types of instrument, but in your syllabus you have to concentrate on what is an absolute instrument and what is a secondary instrument. So what is an absolute instrument? So absolute instrument is an instrument from which I am not able to measure a value directly. For example, this is a picture of a tangent galvanometer, where the tangent galvanometer is used for measuring current. But here you are not able to measure the value of current directly, but instead you get some values like theta. So you will get theta values. So you will get so I value is measured based on this formula, is equal to K tan theta, where H is equal to H1 tan theta. H is directly proportional to tan theta, or H is directly proportional to I. So from these formulas, I can say I is equal to K tan theta. So tangent galvanometer, though it is used for measuring current, you are not able to measure directly the current value from this instrument. So how do you measure? So you should know the magnetic field intensity H. You should know what are the number of turns used for this galvanometer. And you should know the angle of deflection. So you should know three different components: the number of turns in this particular instrument, what is the magnetic field intensity, and what is the angle of this magnetic field intensity. Only if you know all these three datas, you can find out the value of current. So here in absolute instrument, you are not able to measure the value of current directly. Okay, so it is indirect. That is why it is called as indirect instrument. But this absolute instrument are highly precise, and you can measure the values very accurately. So whenever you are measuring a particular instrument, it is always measured against a predefined standard. So absolute instruments are having a predefined standard. So you can always have an undefined quantity which is measured against the predefined standard, which is an absolute instrument. So absolute instrument is an instrument which has a predefined standard. So though you are not able to measure accurately, it is a predefined standard instrument. Next is secondary instrument. So these are different types of secondary instrument. So you can see an ammeter, you can see an thermometer, where you can measure temperature, ammeter to measure current, and this is an instrument to measure pressure. So here in secondary instrument, you can see, you can measure the value directly. So I can measure the value of current directly, it is 5 amps. And in using thermometer also, when you measure the temperature, it will indicate to some value. From that, you can find out the value of temperature. So you can measure it directly. And similarly, here also you have an indicator. You can measure the pressure from this instrument directly. So secondary instruments are instruments from where you can measure the values directly. But these secondary instruments are calibrated from the absolute instrument. So the absolute instrument will be the reference. From the reference value, you will be fabricating all this, you will be manufacturing all these instruments. So that is why it is called as secondary instrument. Secondary instrument, though you are able to measure the values directly, you are calibrating to another instrument, or it is compared with another predefined standard instrument, absolute instrument. So mostly secondary instrument will always have an error. Mostly it will have an error, so you have to calibrate the error. But whereas in an absolute instrument, the absolute instrument will not have an error, and that is the advantage of an absolute instrument. Though the measurement is measuring the value is little difficult, you can measure the value accurately. But whereas in secondary instrument, though you are able to measure the value very easily, you have to compare it with an absolute instrument, or you have to calibrate these instruments. So that is why it is called as secondary instrument. So going back to the classification, so I thought I will give you a small gist of the other divisions, though it is not important later to your syllabus, but I will tell you what is an analog, what is the importance of other instruments. So in secondary or direct instrument, you have classifications like analog instrument and digital instrument. So analog instrument is nothing but the measurement will be in terms of analog. For example, when you measure a sugar, you have a weight. Okay, so it is measured manually. But in digital instrument, so the moment you keep the weight, so you can see weighing machine also in digital, right? So when you keep weight, automatically it will show some value. So from the value, you can find out what is the weight of that particular quantity. So in analog instrument, it will be manual. In digital instrument, you can take the readings digitally. And in analog instrument, it is again classified into two types, deflecting instrument or null deflection instrument. So in secondary instruments, I was showing thermometer, ammeter, and pressurometer. So all these instruments are deflecting instruments. The instruments which I showed you now, the pictures were all deflecting instruments because you have a pointer to show the value. So that is a deflecting instrument. When you have a pointer to show the value, it is a deflecting instrument. And what is null deflection? So the best example for null deflection is when you measure the weight manually. So how do you measure the weight manually? You have a stone which has a weight that is already set or predefined. You have a stone either in kilogram or gram or in half kilogram or 1 kilogram or 100 grams. So that stone weight is fixed already or it is defined. And in the other plate, you will keep the weight which is an unknown quantity. So how do you weigh? When both the plates come to both the plates are balanced, when both the plates are equal, then you say the weight is correct. So that is how it is measured manually. So when both the plates are coming to an equal value, or when both the plates are balanced, then you say the weight is correct. It is the quantity is 1 kilogram or 100 grams. So that is called null deflection. Now null deflection is you have a predefined value, and you keep another weight and you compare and you make it equal. So that is null deflection. So this we rarely use. Mostly we go for deflecting type instrument. In deflecting type, we have indicating instruments. Indicating instruments will have a pointer. Integrating instrument, for example, in house we have energy meter to measure the how much amount of energy is consumed in our house or in a particular company. So we have an energy meter to measure the amount of energy. So that is a integrating instrument. So why it is an integrating instrument? Because it relates with time. Any instrument which is relating to time is an integrating instrument. So you measure the amount of energy consumed for a particular amount of time, for a number of days, for a number of months. So it is integrating instrument. Next is recording instrument. So recording instrument will have some datas or values and variables. From the values and variables, you measure a particular data. So that is recording instrument. So these are different classifications of instrument. So for a syllabus point of view, you should know what is an absolute instrument, why it is called as an absolute instrument, and what are the examples of absolute instrument. And similarly, you should know what is a secondary instrument, why it is called a secondary instrument, what are its advantages, and what are its examples. So again, these are the textbooks used. So the first, I have taken this presentation from the first textbook. Thank you.